What's going on, everyone? KJ here. Let's get right into my thoughts on chapters 932 and 933 of One Piece. So starting off with chapter 932 titled The Shogun and the Courtesan. So Robin's plan to have a double go in the room instead of her was pretty smart, as she was able to escape being captured by the Oniwa Banshu for now. I'm also curious if she can find anything else that may be of use to the crew. The dialogue between the other girls, Kyoshiro, Orochi, Komurasaki, and Robin was pretty interesting, and it was crazy that some of the people at the gathering were actually laughing at Orochi when he was talking about Odin's will and stuff. I was also surprised that Komurasaki actually slapped Orochi to stop him from hurting Otoko, and due to this, we finally got a better look at Orochi's dragon form, which looked pretty cool. Komurasaki also said she was the daughter of a samurai. Could she be hinting at possibly being related to Odin? Maybe. It looks like Robin was also able to save Otoko, but one of the members of the Oniwa Banshu found her, and is probably going to chase her as well. I'm curious to see if Robin and Otoko will be able to get somewhere safe, as well as what will happen to Komurasaki. So rating-wise, I gave this chapter a 4 out of 5 because it was nice. We finally got to see what Orochi's dragon form looks like, and like I said earlier, I'm curious as to what will happen to Komurasaki, as well as if Robin and Otoko can escape from the Oniwa Banshu and get somewhere safe. So after that, we have chapter 933 titled A Samurai's Mercy. In addition to seeing Orochi's dragon form in the previous chapter, we also got the name of his devil fruit, the snake fruit model Yamata no Orochi. Orochi. So I've always liked devil fruit reveals because it's interesting to know about people and their powers in the series. And in all honesty, I didn't expect Orochi's devil fruit to be name dropped for a while, so it's pretty cool that it was revealed so soon. It was also crazy that Komurasaki was continuing to stand up to Orochi, and because of that, he went wild, destroying things, attacking folks, as well as Komurasaki herself. Even the Oniwa Banshu wouldn't try to stop Orochi, as they were preoccupied with capturing Robin, even though the greater issue at hand should really be calming down Orochi, as once again, he's going bonkers right now. It was great that Brook came to help out the two, and we also got to see Robin actually attack somebody, something that hasn't happened in a long time, so seeing that was awesome too. The antics with Shinobu were pretty funny too, and she also came through clutch as she collapsed the ceiling, causing Orochi to undo his grasp on Komurasaki. I also, this big moment right here, big moment. I didn't expect Kyoshiro to just straight up kill Komurasaki, as many folks were saying that Kyoshiro would actually attack Orochi for trying to attack Komurasaki. But who knows? I mean, maybe he did something, or maybe he made it look like he killed her. You know, we don't know. Kyoshiro also had the note related to Kinemon gathering up forces. Could he be one of the strong individuals mentioned in the past, or did he wind up finding this paper in the scuffle, potentially allowing him to find out about Luffy and the Allies' plans? Something interesting to think about. Nami also came through clutch in this chapter. She was able to use Zeus to unleash a devastating thunder attack on Orochi, which was awesome. Meanwhile, we got to see Chopper and the others, as well as Big Mom, now known as Olin. I heard how some folks didn't like Big Mom having amnesia, and after giving it some more thought, I'll admit as well, it is somewhat a bad plot device somewhat. But at the same time, I'm excited to see how Big Mom can factor into Luffy and the Allies' plan. So hopefully if she does get her memory back, it's after the group has accomplished what they need to do in Wano, you know? There are also only 9 days left until the final battle, so I'm definitely looking forward to what happens. So anyway, I gave this one a 5 out of 5 because it was pretty awesome. We got a lot of great and crazy stuff. The name drop of Orochi's devil fruit. Kyoshiro killing Komurasaki, or maybe he didn't. We'll have to see. Although he might be an ally for Luffy and the Allies, but once again, we'll have to see. Nami using Zeus to attack Orochi, etc. I'm just definitely excited for what's to come. But that's pretty much it with this double chapter review. Let me know your thoughts on these chapters in the comments down below. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a like. And if you're new here, hit the subscribe button. And be sure to hit the notification bell so you're notified of all my uploads. But until next time, I'll see y'all later.